Hi, it's Mr. Biscuit here. Today I want to bring you a huge update to my plugin Instance Utils, which enables the most seamless workflow to slots. Here, let me show you how it works. I have here a file upload list, and over on the left hand side you can see a bunch of slots, all the way down to atomic level. But you know, in Figma, we're not allowed to directly change the layer structure inside of an instance. But unfortunately, that's exactly what I'm gonna do. Let's have four items inside of this list. Let's change the icon. And I wanna put it to the right. And let's swap the titles. And let's give it a bit of rotation. I think that's perfect. Even after that, everything still works as you'd expect. As you can see, the variance on this instance still works perfectly fine. So you can basically just mess around however you want. And as long as you have instance utils open, and as long as you have slots, yeah. There are, however, some criteria you need to follow in order to build a good slot. Number one rule is that you cannot have any important properties on a slot because they will be lost in the process, except for auto layout. If you're not using auto layout, I don't know what you're doing in Figma. You must have auto layout applied on basically every layer. So now let me break down how a list like this can be achieved. Let's build our first component, and we're gonna call it item. Notice how in item we already have a slot in place. Let's add a variant to it and probably just call it probably gonna give it a different icon. Now that we have our item ready, let's make multiple of it. Shift A to add auto layout, Command Option K to make it a component. This is gonna be a slot, by the way. And we're just gonna name this slot item list. So now let's put it into a real component. Grab the header, and this is going to be our upload list. And let's adjust a bit of the padding. So that's it, we're done. So that's how you can use slots with the help of instance utils, and guess I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.